Good afternoon, everyone. It's good to see you. I can't see all of you at one time, but I can see a fair amount of you. My name is Diane Harival, and I am coming to you from the Pacific Northwest, just north of Seattle in Lake Stevens, where I live. And I am taking a break in my workday, actually working today. I'm a marriage and family therapist, and I'm working fully remotely right now. So I'm used to doing this. And so it's very good to see you all. And I'm hoping that this first session, I guess it was afternoon your time, it's still morning my time, was just a wonderful time for you. And this session right now is for us to just take a little time to share. Anybody has feedback, if there was an insight for you, or if the Lord touched you in some way, a new truth. So I'm just going to open it up, and I think Neil's going to help here a little bit, because I can't see all at the same time. If you have something that you feel you would love to share with all of us, because we know that the Lord blesses not only those of us who share, but those of us who hear the testimonies of what God is doing. So I would just invite you to put your little hand emoji up there, and Neil's going to help us, I think, with that, and invite you to unmute yourselves, because again, I can't see all the screens. So if anyone has something, please feel free to share with us the good things that God is doing. So Neil, if you see someone and you can just let them call their name out, and they can unmute themselves, and then we'll just go through that way.
Diane, I'm not seeing any hands raised. So if you've raised your hand, oh wait, I see a hand has gone up. Oh, we lost Diane.
Hi, I'm Rosie from San Diego. I haven't been a member of the Order of St. Luke for very long, a couple of years. But one thing that really struck me today that I need to remember for a long time to come is that I didn't say yes just once. I have to say yes every single day. Otherwise, I leave myself open for temptations and evil things to happen, or just boredom, whatever. It's still, you know, bad stuff. So please try to remember to say yes to Jesus every single day. Thank you.
Diane, you have to unmute yourself. Diane.
Oop, there we go. Sorry. I'm a little new at this, but just thanks for sharing that, because we do have to just start our day and say, Lord, what do you have for me? So thank you, Rosie. I see Cindy.
Good morning. I'm from San Diego as well. And I signed up for this conference because I just finished last month, the 26 Healing of Jesus course, and kind of led me to on the journey of intercessory prayer. And one of the things in that class, they talked about armoring up. And so this is why I'm taking this class here. So as Saran was talking about what has God revealed as I'm armoring up and what to pray for specifically about myself, is that he put on my heart anxiety. And I typically don't think of myself as a person of having anxiety. There's other things that I can just rattle off, but that came to me today. So if this is something, anxiety and selfishness were the two things from today, this morning. So if those are the two things that I have got to be in prayer about, As I embark on being an intercessory prayer warrior, then this is what God has put in front of me, and I need to do that.
There we go. Thank you for sharing that, Cindy. We all have different things that the Lord will at times put his finger on for us. And it's always invitational and not blaming, but invitational for us to just bring it to him so that he can continue to work these things out. Because we're all works in progress, right? Mm-hmm. Anyone else? I can't see anyone on my screen, but maybe on some of the other screens. Anyone else? If you can unmute yourself too, if you don't see anyone else jumping in there. Deb.
Hi. Yeah. Hear me? Yeah. Okay. The devotional, the visualization of Jesus hugging me and touching my face and taking my problems and turning them into butterflies flying away. I have turned into a butterfly myself. I have been my problem, trying to fix my daughter and fix other people and get them to do things I think they should be doing. And I'm getting out of the way, and it feels wonderful. Thank you.
What a beautiful picture. I think all of us could kind of vision what you were just speaking. And the Lord is so good to give us these. And sometimes we go, I could never have made that up, right? And that's the Holy Spirit just speaking to our heart. And he is so personal for each one of us. We have time for maybe just a couple more because we got started just a teeny bit late. So anybody else have something? These things bless us. They bless us all. So if you don't be shy, because, you know, this is how we learn how God works in it, and we all rejoice together. So anyone else?
This is Marge Rogers from Long Island. And the Order of the Daughters of the King and the Episcopal Church has been praying fervently for the situation in the Ukraine. And at my church, we make a lot of winter hats for children and adults and quilts for adults and children. And the Lord opened up a Ukrainian church on Long Island, and they took some of our supplies to the Ukraine, and we're just so thankful.
That's beautiful. You know, we are blessed, and then we can be a blessing, you know, and that comes out in many different ways. We can bless by interceding for people. We can bless by providing for people's physical needs, and the Lord cares about all of that. And so thank you for sharing that. Maybe one more, anyone?
I'm Fern Powers from Ontario, Canada. I had never heard of the Order of St. Luke until I came across this session. And I'm just so glad that I did. The Lord has just been leading me recently into healing. That he has come to heal us all. And this is just so powerful to me. And I just see the Lord restoring his people across the world. And you are all a part of that. And I just want to thank God for each one of you. God bless you.
There we go. Welcome, Fern, to Discovering. This is a community. It's like a family. And we just listen and support each other. We listen, love, and pray. And I'm just thrilled that you are here today to experience what God has for you. So I'm going to turn it over now to Kathy Stanton, who's our wonderful musician. I just love Kathy. So she has a song for you. And then I'll be back real briefly after that. So thanks.
And before I offer a song, if you would all join me in prayer. So please close your eyes and bow your head as we say a great praise and thank you for all of the hearts that are touched today. I feel the Holy Spirit. Thank the Holy Spirit for showing up. There is no time or distance to God or the Spirit. He is here. I thank for all of our hearts being open to hearing this message. I want to say a thank you for all the silent prayers. We had a time of sharing, but I want to say a thank you and a praise for every silent prayer and noticing that is happening right now as we are listening. Rosie, your Say Yes Every Day, a deep appreciation for your sharing. For Saran's message, thank you for the armor that we have put on this morning to prepare us, and for lifting all of our burdens, all those rocks that became butterflies. Deb, thank you for that vision, that sharing of what you saw. Deep thank you. And for all the needs that we have in the world, as a moment of prayers of the people, lift up for any hurt and any harm that is happening in the world, that your presence is laid over the top of that and penetrates that and changes that. Because he is leading us to a healing that we may not even yet know that we need. I feel the power. I really do this morning. I'm blown away. And I want to, as Saran often does, anoint this prayer and say that in Jesus' name, we make all these praises and thank yous and observations and burdens that are put down are lifted from us. In Jesus' name, amen. And Saran has asked me to share just a little bit about myself and then sing a song for you that is an original. I've seen in the chat that the songs in the first session might be originals. They are not. They are by wonderful artists, and I believe if I don't remember to put the names of the artists in the chat, I will do that later, but they are listed in one of the handouts. So I am going to sing an original, however, because I, as Diane mentioned, I am a musician, and I love music, and I do occasionally write a song. I am a person who is dealing with a health issue myself. And in dealing with that health issue, I've shared that with people who love me. That's one of the ways to respond to a health challenge, is to offer the friends and family and priests and a church family a chance to be supportive of you. And I shared my journey with my priest, happens to be Saran's wonderful husband, Tom Warren, of Church of the Good Shepherd in Vancouver. And he, in a very beautiful pastoral way, shared a prayer with me over email. And it was so uplifting to me. And again, that's the prayers, the power of prayer, the power that can come from external to us, from a friend, from somebody who loves us praying for us, those intercessory prayers that are so important. And it wouldn't leave me alone, so I began the idea of composing a song, which I did, based on his prayer to me. And I'll just share the first lines that are repeated throughout the song. And it's an invitation for the Holy Spirit. The words are, "Come, Lord Christ, and be with your servant. Come, Holy Spirit. Come." And as you listen to me sing this song, know that it comes from a deep place of joy and recognition that the Holy Spirit answers that call and comes. So this is called "Come, Lord Christ," or Father Tom's Prayer. Come, Lord Christ,
Amen. Kathy, that's so beautiful. Thank you so much. Your voice just lifts us into the presence of the Lord. So thank you for that beautiful gift.
You hear that?
So I am now, can y'all hear me okay? I'm hopeful. I'm hearing. Somebody else talking, but I don't quite know what that is, but we'll just keep going here. So I want to talk to you just briefly a little bit about the Order of St. Luke. And first, we just want to thank the Holy Spirit for being here. And I also want to say that each of us is here by design. We're not, it's not an accident that we are here. The Lord has drawn us to be here today. And different reasons, because he's so personal. But some of us have been in OSL for a long time. I haven't been in too long. And some of us haven't even known much about OSL. And I remember the very first time that I came to an event and I really didn't know very much. I was invited to come by a good friend and I knew I needed something. I was feeling kind of dry and I came and we just don't know where the Lord is going to lead us, because I ended up going up to become what we now call a discerning member. And that wasn't what I had plan to do. In fact, I sat there and argued with the Lord for a little bit because I thought, I need to know more about this. And my heart was going bung, bung, bung. And I just thought, Saran was so patient. She just said, is there anybody else? I finally went, I think she's talking to me. So, you know, and now I'm a convener of a small little group at my own church. And over the last 2 years, 2+ years, and it's been such a blessing. I can't even begin to tell you. So when we are blessed and healed, then we can in turn be a blessing. And what is a blessing? But it is to become all that we can be. The Lord wants us each to become all that we can be. And so then as we, in process, because we're all in process, we don't have to wait till we have it all together, right? Wherever we are, we can bless back with what we have been given and what we've received. OSL, the Order of St. Luke, is all about the ministry of healing and blessing. Its purpose was to kind of bring back that healing ministry into local churches and communities, which sort of had fallen away from the church. You know, Jesus meant for that to be part of what the church does, not just preaching and teaching, but also healing. And we got a little gun shy about it. And so OSL exists to train people to create these healing communities, which are like families, so that we learn to pray for one another in this way. And then we just don't know where the Lord's going to place us, and it's okay, because he's not going to put us where he won't equip us. So, you know, when Jesus launched his mission, he said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach good news to the poor and sent me to proclaim release to the captives, the recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And so that was Jesus' ministry, and Jesus commissioned his disciples, but all of us too, to that same ministry. And we go, "Oh, just me, little me, never say that," because you just don't know. So we give back, we bless the Lord, you know, and all that is within me, with the gifts that he's giving us, given us internally, with any kinds of blessings with ourselves, and also with our material gifts. Because that, as we are flourishing, how God blesses us, our gifts can cause OSL to be able to flourish and become in its ministry of what we're doing today, reaching out and making a place for people to come and listen and test it out and see how good the Lord is. Taste and see how good is the Lord to us. So I'm going to invite you to be prayerful and to ask the Lord, what would he have you give to OSL? It can be a small amount. Nothing is too small. 5 loaves and 2 little fish. And Jesus multiplied that to feed the multitude, right? So we don't discount. If that's all we can do, it's something. It's a giving from our heart and ourselves. And so then we also want to say, you know, Lord, are you calling me into this organization? Are you calling me to learn more? Are you tugging on my heart to become a member of this organization? Or even just to come and be part of a healing community and listen and learn. So I want you to consider that, because many in this organization have had this picture of these little lights all over the place of communities expanding and growing. And then we network together in regions. So we have support, and it's a beautiful family. It really is. It's amazing. And the pandemic, all it did was like blow the dandelion seeds. So now it's everywhere. And now we have online communities, and I wouldn't be able to go to Ohio to attend this conference, but look, here we are all over the place. And we have people from the UK, we have people from Canada and the Bahamas and 26 different states, last I heard. It's amazing. So I just want to invite you to consider that and ask the Lord about it. Now, to give is very simple. You can go online, osltoday.org, and you hit on the menu button, and then there's a place that says donate, and you hit on that, and it's that simple. Or you can look up for the actual address. I had it written down. I'm not sure where I put it. But you can find, oh, there it is. P.O. Box 780909. You're not going to remember that. San Antonio 78278. You can look it up. You can send a check. So I'm just going to ask you, as your spiritual worship, to consider even a very small gift or a large one. If you can give largely, please do. You know, God blesses us in many different ways. So let's pray together. Lord, thank you that you are sowing seeds of blessing for us and for others in need of your healing touch. Lord of the harvest, grant that we might give from a tender and thankful heart to your work of healing, to bless OSL that it may flourish and be all that you intend it to be, for the healing of your precious people, each of whom, all of us, you know by name. Freely, freely we have received. May we now freely, freely give in your precious name, Lord Jesus. Amen.
And as we prepare ourselves to receive another teaching from Saran, she's asked me to lead us in a quiet, meditative song. I will just be singing to you so you can close your eyes and rest in the Spirit. It's the same message. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living God. tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord.
Kathy, thank you, thank you. Is the sound good? I just want to make sure on Zoom if the sound is good, if you need it to go up a little bit. Can you hear me now? Oh, here we go. Holy Spirit, activate, activate, activate. Holy Spirit, activate, activate the sound. Please, por favor. We're back? We are back. Welcome back, everybody. I appreciate your patience with the technical difficulties. We're getting ready to learn about the Holy Spirit and activate the Holy Spirit. And this is powerful stuff. So we just come against the enemy right now. You have no place in this teaching. We are in the name of Jesus. We put the protection back on. And so actually right now, wherever you are, go ahead and stand, because we're going to put on the armor of God again super quickly, because obviously we need to do that. So everybody stand up. And super quickly, first we're going to do the super fast chick, chick, chick. We're going to just right now, what color knight are you today? I say this to my husband when he leaves the house. Sometimes I say it to my kids. They think I'm crazy, but I say, what color knight are you today? So just put it on right now, super fast, top to bottom. What color knight are you? Just yell out what color you are. What are you?
Blue.
Green.
Clear.
Perfect. Okay, so you stand firm, and we are going to say the St. Patrick's breastplate prayer, and then I'm going to invite Gail up here to share a testimony. We had some prayer time last night in person here on the west side of Cleveland at Avon Lake Presbyterian Church, where we are sending out this Zoom time from, and we're just so glad you're joining us from around the world. If you weren't able to be in the first session, that's okay. Welcome to this one, and we're just glad you're with us. So, Kathy, thank you for all your singing. So beautiful, and I just right now want to pray a blessing over you for your health, for continued total healing from the top of your head to the tip of your toes, that your cancer would just be gone in the name of Jesus, and that you would just be stronger and a more mighty warrior in his army more now than ever, and that your music would bless and encourage and change lives in Jesus' name. Amen. So I'm going to repeat the line. So you're all armored up. You can, you know, might as well get the crop, might as well get the sword going, the sword of the Spirit. Might as well get that going. And you can say this, so I'll say the line and then you say it. Christ with me. Christ with me. Christ before me. Christ behind me. Christ in me. Christ beneath me, Christ above me, Christ on my right, Christ on my left, Christ when I lie down, Christ when I sit down, Christ when I arise, Christ in the heart of every man, who thinks of me. Think about that for just a moment. Christ in the heart of every man or woman who thinks of me. That's a beautiful thought right there. Christ in the mouth of everyone who speaks of me. What if that were true? What would they be saying about you? Would they be saying blessings? They would. If Christ is in the mouth of everyone who speaks of you, they are going to be speaking kindness and blessing. So that right there is a great thought. Christ in every eye that sees me. Christ in every ear that hears me. I arise today. I arise today. I arise today to say yes, to say yes, to say yes, yes. Thank you for that reminder, by the way, on Zoom. That was awesome. Through a mighty strength, the invocation of the Trinity, through belief in threeness, through confession of oneness, of the Creator of creation, who is worthy, and his name is Jesus. And we praise you today, Jesus. And we thank you today, Jesus, for loving us and being our Savior and our friends, and we ask you to send again your Holy Spirit Advocate to be with us anew and refreshed anew across the nation and the world, and that the Order of St. Luke would flourish and pop up all across the world. As little, like little fires, fire, 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 fire across the world. Fire, 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 fire across the world to love and bless and heal. In Jesus' name. Amen. All right, so there's power in all of us saying that prayer, so wait and see what happens. So that's awesome. So for all of you that aren't members of the Order of St. Luke, I guess you'll be signing up before you leave. So there's that. No, just kidding. But anyone, anytime, you are personally invited to become a member of the Order of St. Luke. And anybody can do that. You do not need a special credential. You just have to say what? Yes! Yes, that's the word. Okay, you may be seated. And I'm going to invite Gail, who is our new region director elect that Josh talked about in session one, who has a testimony to share. So I wanted to give her a chance. Can you guys make sure this microphone is on? Testing. Okay, here we go.
Thank Gail. You. Mm-hmm. Hello, everyone. Hello, all of you out there. And I just want to say thank you so much for allowing me to be here. I came up here to a four-hour drive approximately to meet some new friends in Christ. And oh my word, you know, he has a really good plan. And I am so grateful, first of all, to be the regional board director elect. And I am grateful for that. And by the grace of Almighty God, I will do my best to do my best. And to have this team of people surrounding me and helping me already has just been a huge blessing. But I have to tell you, you know, the Holy Spirit, he's funny because, and he has a sense of humor. When I drove up here yesterday, I had a little bit of a back challenge, and I've had that before. I have a couple fake hips, back surgery, so when I sit, it can be a little testy, and I was really tested all day and all night last night. But God has such a sense of humor. When we were praying over Saran, and I thank you because I know you were blessed, but I got part of your blessing. Your mama stood behind me and she asked if she could place her hands on my back. Now I have to tell you, I've been with OSL a little over a couple years, and I had to go through the healing, the 26 healing miracles twice. The Lord knew I have a thick head and I needed it, you know? So I went twice. And last night, her mother stood behind me and said, "Do you mind if I place my hand on your hip?" And I was like, "Oh my gosh, that is awesome. This is the healing, you know, that I learned in the miracles, right?" And as she did that, and we were praying over Saran, and I just was like, "Wow, God, I am so blessed to have this lady reach out to me like that," because my back was really testy. And I have to tell you a really quick story. When I got to the hotel, I had called, actually literally called my doctor. And I said, "Could you please call in a prescription for me? Because I have travel the next few weeks and I'm not sure I could do it." She said, "Sure, I'll do that." Do you know, after we finished praying, I had gotten a message. She sent my prescription in, but to the wrong pharmacy. And now it's after hours, the doctors are gone, so I can't even get back to her until Monday, and I will already be long gone on my next journey, right? And I went back to the hotel last night, and I was like, "Oh my gosh, I got out of my car, I could walk. I wasn't in pain." I was like, "Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, wow, Lord, thank you so much, because you surprised me by bringing me here to heal me of hip and back stuff that I've been plagued with for years." And look, seriously, honest to goodness, I had to sit in that hotel parking lot a minute and just give him praise and glory, because I did not see that coming. So I give him all the glory. And if you're not part of OSL, as Saran said, please join. Please bring your friends. And you know, I'm a convener and wherever we all are. And I just ask you guys, if you're listening, you're watching, please bring friends to join this organization, because now I am firsthand healed by those 26 miracles that we learned about in Jesus' time. So thank you, Carol. Thank you. Bless you all.
So let's give Gail a hand. That's great news. Thank you for sharing that. So that's just, we did have a very special prayer time last night. And so it's just a joy to be together in person for the first time, and the fact that this church opened up so that we could be here together and connected with all of you. We're just so glad to be together. So now that we have, and the people who are listening on Zoom, if you want to type into the chat what color knight you are right now, if you decide to change your outfit mid you know, teaching or stream, you can do that, because all you have to do is close your eyes and go and you can change your outfit. So if you want to change it, totally fine with us. You can do that anytime. So what we're going to do now is, we've already heard some of the Holy Spirit activate, or the people here, when the camera went off and the sound went off, we went into our Holy Spirit activate chant and cheer. But I have a background story to this. And so what's fascinating about this as we go into the session on the Holy Spirit is, first of all, what is it, what gift from the Holy Spirit do you desire today? And we're going to go talk a little bit about in Scripture. We're going to talk about the gifts of the Holy Spirit, and we're going to talk about the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Okay, two different things, but they all work together. And the point of the Holy Spirit is to empower us so that then we can bless and empower others and help draw them closer to Jesus. So the Holy Spirit helps us get closer to Jesus, and then we help others get closer to Jesus. So blessed people bless others. Healed people heal others. Okay, so the Holy Spirit, we're going to do this little chant in a second, but when I first learned about this, you know, in this day and age when there's so much going on in the world, and there's it's hard to watch some of the news these days. And so when our family wants to have a break from that, guess what channel we turn on? Well, there's a couple. Sometimes we go to the food channel. Sometimes we go to HGTV. But most of the time, if we want to laugh, and laughter's important, we go to the game show network. Okay. And our favorite game that we like to watch together when we just want to be brainless and just be and just have some fun is Family Feud with Steve Harvey. Well, this one in particular, we're watching Family Feud, and we've watched a ton of episodes, and we love to shout out the answers. And I would love one day to be on that show. I think it would be so much fun to be on that show. But here's the Warne family. Like, it would be hilarious. Anyway, so we were watching the show, and this is a charity version of it. And the Wilson Phillips sisters are on the show, and they're at the end session where they're trying to win the $20,000 to give to their charity. And the one sister's come out and want, she had like, what, 120 points. They have to get to 200. So she needed 80 points. So China Phillips, who's the sister, comes out. And Steve Harvey's like, your sister did well, you need 80 more points. She's like, she goes, okay, hold on just a second, Steve. He's like, okay, like, and she goes, Holy Spirit, activate, activate, activate. Holy Spirit, activate, activate, let's go. And Steve Harvey was, he's never speechless. Like, he just went, like, what just happened on Family Feud? That's never happened before. And she starts wanting to go in it again. She's like, oh, he goes, wait, hold on. He goes, hold on. He goes, I'll tell you when to do that again, but not yet. And she's like, okay. So then she answers the question. She gets the 80, and then they're all, he goes, okay, you can do it now. And then she, Holy Spirit, activate, activate, activate. So what we're going to do today together is we're going to do it together, which when it went off bar, when the sound was gone and the video was gone, we were all doing that here. So it does work. We know it works. And when the sound was gone, then they're like, come on, one more time. So it does work. So I want everyone, if you can, I invite you all to stand, because we're going to do this together. If you can't stand, you may do it seated. So if you stand, we're going to do it, but then we're going to add things like, for example, so we're going to do it together. And we're going to do it, first of all, with the Holy, with actually with the Holy Spirit. So we're going to, this is, and I used, you got to understand, I'm trained in being a kindergarten teacher. That's the only grade I've ever taught. And now I'm with the 6th through 12th graders doing youth group, and there are overlaps there with, like, you know, tools in your pocket. But I just want you to know we're going to have a little kindergarten fun together, because you have to be a little crazy to be a kindergarten teacher. So here you go. We're getting the Holy Spirit, and this is the one where you just cross your hands and you connect the thumbs. And if you can't do it that way, then do it this way. It doesn't matter. Okay. So it's super easy because you repeat it 3 times and we go, Holy Spirit, activate, 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 Holy Spirit, activate, activate, let's go. Because after it's activated, it's not just for you. It's like you're going out, you're going into the world, you're doing things, you're with Jesus. Jesus is sending you his advocate. He's like, let's go, let's go. So we're gonna do it again. And then this time we're just gonna do it clapping. So cheer, give me an A. No, just kidding. Here we go. Holy Spirit, activate, activate, activate. Holy Spirit, activate, activate. Let's go. Okay, excellent. Okay, now this time we're going to say, Holy Spirit, bless my child. So we're going to put words in. And if you can think of a phrase of something you want to have us throw into this, then you can tell me, because I will take that from you and we'll put it in there. So we're gonna say, bless my child. And if you don't have a child, you know a child. So it will bless someone. And if you have a certain child in mind, then have that person in mind when you're saying this, okay? Holy Spirit, bless my child, bless my child, bless my child. Holy Spirit, bless my child, right now. Okay, good, 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 okay. So let's just do, we're going to do bless my family, because that includes everyone. So just think of these people in your family, all these people you love. And then I'm going to ask for someone to shout out something that we're going to bless. We're going to bless our family now, okay? Ready? Holy Spirit, bless my family, bless my family, bless my family. Holy Spirit, bless my family. Let's go. Okay, give me one. Grandchild, okay, bless my grandchild, let's do it. Holy Spirit, bless my grandchild, bless my grandchild, bless my grandchild. Holy Spirit, bless my grandchild, right now. Okay, another one.
The world.
The world, does the world need a blessing right now? Yes, right, we all have the Ukraine and on our hearts 100% and all the people that are a part of this, and we want protection for them and blessings and peace. So yes, the world, so bless the world. Holy Spirit, bless the world, bless the world, bless the world. Holy Spirit, bless the world, right now. All right, another one.
My son.
My son, okay, think of your son. And if you don't have a son, you know a son that needs to be blessed. So here we go. Holy Spirit, bless my son, bless my son, bless my son. Holy Spirit, bless my son, right now. Okay, another one.
Daughter.
Yeah, yes, that's good. All right. Holy Spirit, bless my daughter, bless my daughter, bless my daughter. Holy Spirit, bless my daughter, right now. Okay. Minister, awesome. That's my minister. Bless my minister. That's gonna be good. That's a good. Okay. Here we go. Holy Spirit, bless my minister. Bless my minister. Bless my minister. Holy Spirit, bless my minister. Bless my minister. Right now. Okay. And for any of you that are priests or ministers or in ministry, thank you. Thank you. You have no idea the seeds of love that you plant and touch. So just please be encouraged by that. It's really important what you do. Okay, give me another one.
My body.
Ah, excellent. Bless my body. Yes. Who here has a body? Ah, yes. Okay, here we go. Holy Spirit, bless my body, bless my body, bless my body. Holy Spirit, bless my body, right now. Okay. My work, yes, good one. You guys are good at this, yeah. Holy Spirit, bless my work, bless my work, bless my work. Holy Spirit, bless my work, bless my work. Right now. Okay, another one. Anyone having fun? Is anyone having fun? Spouse. Good one. Yes, because spouse includes man or woman. Depending. Yeah, you're very smart. Here we go. Holy Spirit, bless my spouse, bless my spouse, bless my spouse. Holy Spirit, bless my spouse, right now. Okay? Anyone else?
Sister.
Sister? What were you going to say, Beth?
Sister.
Sister. Were you going to say sister too? Wow, all sisters. Wow. Were you going to say sister too? Okay, what were you going to say?
First responders.
Oh, yeah, excellent. So let's do sisters and then first responders. And then, but you can do this anytime, right? Because blessings can be from a distance or near, and this is a way to bless. And it's God that does the blessing, and in the power of the Holy Spirit is everywhere. Okay, so bless my sister. Holy Spirit, bless my sister, bless my sister, bless my sister. Holy Spirit, bless my sister, right now. And first responders, okay. Holy Spirit, bless first responders, bless first responders, bless first responders. Holy Spirit, bless first responders, right now. Okay, so we just say, let's just say bless the world. We did the world, didn't we? We did the world. Okay, so you all and you all on Zoom have just helped bless the world. You've blessed the world, and we're going to keep doing all that. And Michael, it's true. We need to bless OSL, and that will truly be our last one for now. Okay, but we're going to do it this way. Holy Spirit, bless OSL, bless OSL, bless OSL. Holy Spirit, bless OSL, bless OSL. Right now, yay, give yourself a hand. Woo, good job. All right, you may be seated. Good job, that's excellent. Good stuff. That we could do that for a really, really, really long time, and that was excellent. Okay, so the question is now, what is the Holy Spirit? Who is the Holy Spirit? And this was really fun to get in the Bible. If you haven't gotten in the Word of God yet during Lent, I just commend you to get into the Bible. This is the Bible I brought with me. I did all my notes in here. Do you see all my little, like, this was all just going through, finding verses, different. It is so amazing how alive the Word of God is. It truly is, and it doesn't matter how many times you've read it, it will come at you a different way another time. So if you haven't gotten into the Word this Lent, I commend it to you. And if you need help getting into the Word, just join OSL, get into a 26 healing study, which you will cover all the healing scripture of Jesus, and you get connected with people from all over the United States, Canada, and the world in the conversation, and then you find community, and it's amazing. So I just commend that to you. So the Holy Spirit is our advocate, our friend, and our helper. Say, the Holy Spirit is my friend.
The Holy Spirit is my friend.
The Holy Spirit advocates for me.
The Holy Spirit advocates for me.
The Holy Spirit prays for me.
The Holy Spirit prays for me.
And the Holy Spirit blesses me.
The Holy Spirit blesses
me. So then in my own mind, for my own question, I wanted to answer, when is the first time the Holy Spirit is mentioned in the Bible? And so it happens to be in Genesis 1, 1 through 2. Very, very beginning of the Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. The Spirit of God, just this image is so beautiful. The Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. The beginning of the creation of the world, the Holy Spirit is there. And God said, let there be light, and there was light. And God, I mean, just said it. He just spoke it. If God can speak light, what can he do for you? What can he do for me? It's just he spoke it. God saw that the light was good, and he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. But in him is there darkness. In him there is no darkness at all, because Christ is the light of the
world.
The light of the world. Just marinate on that for just a moment. The light of the world wants to commune with you, wants to hang out with you, wants to be your best friend. The light of the world wants to be your best friend, wants to carry your burdens, wants to set you free, wants to advocate for you. That is amazing and glorious. And all we have to do is what? Say, yes. Yes, I want your light in me. Say, yes, I want your light in me. Yes, I want you to advocate for me. Yes, I want you to heal me. Yes, I want you to bless me. Because you are awesome. You're awesome, God. You're awesome. So the Holy Spirit was around from the beginning of the creation of the world. And the Hebrew word for the word hover is the verb merahefet, meaning to hover or move above something, like an eagle hovers over its young in protection. So the Holy Spirit doesn't just hover for the sake of hovering. The Holy Spirit hovers to what?
Protect.
And that is how this all ties into armor up, because the Holy Spirit is all about armoring up. The Holy Spirit naturally helps us armor up with the fruits of the Spirit, with the gifts of the Spirit, so that then we can go out and give those gifts to the world, because we know the world is hurting. We know the people of the world are hurting. God knows the people of the world are hurting, and that's why Jesus came, to bless. And so it takes us to the famous, beautiful verse, Isaiah 40:31. Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will do what? They will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary, and they will walk and not grow faint. But it's all hope in the Lord. Not next to the Lord, not under the Lord, not near the Lord. It's in the Lord. And we know when Peter was watching Jesus walking on the water, and he's like, come on, come on, come on out with me. And Peter's like, I can't do that. He said, keep your eyes on me. And when our eyes are on Jesus, when Peter stepped out of that boat, and we're all called to step out of the boat, Peter steps out of the boat and keeps his eyes on Jesus, what happens? He walks on the water. And when he starts to look away, what happens? Starts to sink. This is our story. This is what happens to us. We've got to keep our eyes on Jesus. We've got to keep asking for the Holy Spirit to come. And we've got to just keep leaning in, because when we do that, no matter what is happening around us, and we can promise you chaos, and we can promise you negative things are going to happen, you will not sink in the water if your eyes are fixed on Jesus. And that is really good news. Really good news. Say, Jesus, I want to keep my eyes fixed on you. Because if we say things out loud, it adds power to what is happening. So, for example, if you love somebody, you could love someone and never tell them that. But when you speak your love over someone or with someone, it carries great power. I love you. I honor you. When you bless somebody intentionally and when you look them in the eye, it is life-changing stuff. I bless you to flourish with all the gifts that God has given you. We've learned to do that with our sons. I'm blessed to have parents who bless me. And then my husband does such a beautiful job of blessing his sons and telling them, I bless you to flourish with all the gifts that God has given you. I am proud of you just as you are. All these things are so, so important and so profound. So if you have a child or a grandchild or a spouse that you haven't said either I love you or I bless you or I appreciate you, it's really, really a beautiful gift if you can give that to another human being. And you can never overgift that. You can never say it too much. So I want to encourage you today to realize the power of the promises of God and the power that comes with them. And so Jesus, the other question then I asked myself, I'm like, well, then when is the Holy Spirit, when does it come up again in the Bible? We know it's early in Genesis. So now we look at Jesus, and I'm like, well, how was that with Jesus? Well, we know when he got baptized, the Spirit of God came out like a what? A dove, and descended upon him, and we heard the Lord say, we heard God say, this is my son with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. Listen to him. So that's another thing that we can probably increase if we can listen a little bit more to what God is saying to us. And the Holy Spirit will whisper things in our ears if we just listen. So Jesus knew scripture by heart. He knew the promises of God, and how do we know this? Well, he went into the wilderness, and what happened? He got tempted by the devil, and how did the devil tempt him? He tempted him with promises and with scripture, but how did Jesus combat the enemy? With scripture. So this is what happened. So this is John chapter 4, verses 1 through 13. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, left the Jordan and was led by the Holy Spirit, full of the Holy Spirit and led by the Holy Spirit. We are called to do the same. Be full of the Holy Spirit and then be led by the Holy Spirit into the wilderness. Have you ever been in the wilderness before? Yes, if you're a human being, you have been in the wilderness. Okay? God, guess what? He's in the wilderness with you. Because God is everywhere. The Holy Spirit hovers, not just over the waters, but over all creation. Where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. So he ate nothing during those days, and at the end of them, he was hungry. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, tell this stone to become bread." And Jesus answered, "It is written." Jesus didn't have a book with him. It was in his heart. He knew these by heart. He said, "It is written, man shall not live on bread alone." The devil led him up a high place and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And he said to Jesus, I will give you all authority and splendor. It has been given to me, and I can give it to anyone I want. If you worship me, it'll be all yours. And Jesus answered once again. He said, it is written. He began with the same three words. It is written. It's written on his heart because he knows it. He's known it from being a young child. Worship the Lord your God and serve him only. The devil led him to Jerusalem and had him stand on the highest point of the temple. If you are the Son of God, he said. See, right there, right now, he's already thrown doubt into Jesus' ear, like, if you are, because Jesus knows he's the Son of God. He's like, if you, like, are you really? If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here. For it is written, he will command his angels concerning you to guard you carefully. They will lift you up on their hands so you will not strike your foot against a stone. Jesus answered once again, it is written. It's written in what? The word of God, which is your sword of the spirit, which is your power to combat the enemy, just like Jesus is doing in the wilderness. Do not put the Lord your God to the test. When the devil had finished all his tempting, he left until an opportune time. Well, just like we talked about before, the devil is going to keep talking negative things into your ears. He did it to Jesus. He does it to human beings on a daily basis. And if we don't have a way to combat that, then we are just going to be a mess. So we have got to have these tools where we recognize, repel, and replace the negative message in the lives with a promise of God. So these I am verses, these are all in your handouts. These, I just commend these to you, and I'm just going to walk up and down here and just say some of them over you, and I want you to take them into heart because these are true, these are real, and these are life-changing. So after I say, okay, you are a temple of the Holy Spirit, I want you to say, I am a temple of the Holy Spirit. You are a temple of the Holy Spirit. You are walking in love. You are a beloved child of God. You are not a victim, but an overcomer. You are forgiven. You are healed by his stripes. You are walking in love. You are listened to by God your Father. You are never alone. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. And then you're going to say that one again, because if you're going to leave here knowing that verse. You're going to leave here knowing that verse, and you're going to be a part of the OSL family. Isn't that great? All in the same day. It's fantastic. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can get. I can start a new job with the strength that Christ gives me. I can reach out and reconcile with the strength that God gives me. I can forgive with the strength that God gives me.
I can forgive with the strength that God gives me.
I can try new things with the strength that God gives me.
I can try new things with the strength that God gives me.
I can pray for the world with the strength that God gives me.
I can pray for the world with the strength that God gives me.
I can have my body healed with the strength that God gives me. I can make new friendships with the strength that God gives me. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
And that is the truth of God, because it is written that that is a truth of God. So now let's go to another truth of God, and let's talk about the fruits of the Spirit, because the fruits of the Spirit is found in Galatians 5:22, and this was part of being in the youth group. I don't know if I was, even before that, probably Sunday school, we had to memorize the fruits of the Spirit. I don't know why, but that was one of the things we did, and I say thank you to the Presbyterian Church for helping me learn scripture, because when I played Bible trivia with my in-laws, and if you're still listening, they know this well, I was teamed up against my husband and his father, who they're both Episcopal priests, and it was me and Fran against them, and we were kicking their butts because of the Presbyterian background, and they're like, how do you know that? How do you know the answer to that? I'm like, Presbyterian! Scripture! It is written! And like one of the questions was like, who was the person that was like chaffing wheat in the fields or gleaning wheat in the fields? I'm like, Ruth! They're like, how do you know that? I'm like, Presbyterian! Anyway, so it's good stuff. So it's important. It's important. And in Sunday school, we were given chocolates. Maybe that's why I learned so much. We had chocolate prizes. So whatever Sunday school teacher thought of chocolate for awards, I was motivated. So I learned a lot of scripture. So Galatians 5:22, the fruits of the Spirit are, and if you know, you can say them with me, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, and self-control. So there's eight of them. But the first three, love, joy, peace. Right? Those are all super important, but there's some really wonderful ones. Self-control we don't hear about as much. We don't think of that as a fruit of the Spirit. Maybe kindness we don't think about it as a fruit of the Spirit. These are all super important qualities. Just say, Lord, I want more fruits of the Spirit.
Lord, I want more fruits of the
Spirit. I want them all. I want all the fruits of the Spirit. I want them to bubble up in me. Like a tree sprouting freshly.
Like a tree sprouting freshly.
I want to eat them all. I want them to be in me so that I can give them out. So I do want you in particular, though, in those to think and pray about maybe if there's one or two or three or four that bubble up more that you say, you know what, I would like that one more. Just jot it down if you happen to have a pen, or just think it in your heart, because we will have an opportunity at the end of this teaching to ask for things in particular that we would like. But at this point, I want you to know too, when we do go to the tree of life where the fruit will be, it is perfectly okay to want them all, because love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And gentleness gets underrated. No one talks about gentleness. Think about if we had more gentleness in our world, more kindness, more self-control. It'd be a different world. Just imagine if everyone had the fruits of the Spirit activated in them, truly activated, it would be world transformationally changed. The world would be changed, okay? Now you can be part of the change makers to help make that happen, but it begins with you, because we can only do for us what we can only do this for ourselves. We can bless others with what we have, but we can't change others, but we can make the change in ourselves. So, there's the fruits of the Spirit, and then there's the gifts of the Spirit. So we're going to talk about the gifts of the Spirit are in 1 Corinthians 12:4-31. There are eight of them. Now there are a variety of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of service, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but is the same God that empowers them all in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. Say, it's for the common good. It's for the common good. It's for the world. Say it's for the world. It's not for yourself. I mean, they bless you too, but it's to build up the common good, okay? It's to build up God's people. For to one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom. Say wisdom. Okay, that's the first one they list here. So you can write it down or you don't have to, but I want you to start thinking, because when you go to Jesus, you might be like, I'd really like a dose of wisdom today. Whatever that may be. And to another, the utterance of knowledge. Say knowledge. According to the same Spirit. To another, faith. Say faith. By the same Spirit. See, faith is it's a gift. It is a gift. And we forget that. It's a beautiful gift. We all need faith. Who doesn't want faith? Say, I want faith. Right? You can also ask for all of these. It's okay to ask for them all. This is a good greedy. Because it's for the what? It's for the common good. It's for the world. Okay. Faith. And by the same Spirit, into another, gifts of healing. Say gifts of healing. By the one Spirit, into another, the working of miracles. Say miracles. Who doesn't want to be a miracle worker? I mean, come on. We don't have enough of that. More miracles is good. To another, prophecy. Say prophecy. To another, the ability to distinguish between spirits. To another, various kinds of tongues. Say tongues. Now this one, and then to another, the interpretation of tongues. Say interpretation of tongues. So for tongues and interpretation of tongues, and the only thing that I want to say about the gift of tongues is that it is a gift of the Holy Spirit for the common good to bless and build up other people, basically in Jesus' name. So, and which are all the gifts are for that purpose. And the interpretation of tongues is to help the body understand what is being prayed for someone else. Now, you don't have to have the gift of tongues to have faith. And there's no one is more important than the other, because they're all important, and some are given to others, and some, you know, they get spread out because there are many parts. And this is the whole thing that we need to remember. When we're talking about these gifts, it's really important to remember and not to do this. That's what that person has. I want what they have. I want to be like them. Nope, don't even go down that rabbit hole. You just keep your eyes on Jesus. Ask him for what he thinks you need the most. Because guess what? Even more than you know, Jesus knows what you need. So in the quiet of your heart, it's really important to say to Jesus, Jesus, would you give me what I most need? Can you say that? Jesus, can you give me what I most need for the common good? Because I want to help build up the world. Okay, that's important, because just as the body has many members, all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we're all made to drink of one Spirit. So the goal of the Holy Spirit is to empower you to lead others to Jesus and be a blessing to others. So the only thing I want to say about the tongues is it's a beautiful gift. If you've ever heard people singing in tongues, or if you've been prayed over with the gift of tongues, it is a blessed, beautiful experience. But not everybody has been in a place where they're able to have that experience, or they want that experience, but they don't know how to get that experience. The only thing I have to say about that is if one of your heart's desire is to receive the gift of tongues, don't be afraid to ask. Do not be afraid to ask, because at some point it's probably going to happen for you. But you do, just don't give up on that if that's something that you want. If you want the gift of faith, or if you want the gift of knowledge, or if you want more the gift of healing and more healing to flow from you, more confidence of that, ask. Don't be afraid. No fear. Perfect love casts out fear. This is not a time in the world to be afraid. This is a time to be bold and to lean in with God's authority. Not our authority, with God's authority. Because these are all gifts of the Spirit. They're all come from God, which is amazing. It's just incredible. When I was 16 years old, and Marcia's sitting right here, it all comes back to like this area. There's this like womp that comes out here. So when I was 16 in high school, my mom was part of a prayer team at Bay Presbyterian Church and invited me when I was a sophomore in high school. We must have had the day off school or something. Do you want to come pray with my prayer team? I was like, sure, yeah, I'll go. And we're there, and Marcia's in the prayer group. And who else was in the prayer group? There was two other people. Anyway, so we're there praying, and they're just like, do you want to receive the gift of tongues? Do you want us to pray for that for you? And I'm 16, and I know a little bit about it because my mom had received the gift prior to that, so I was familiar with it. And I was like, sure. But here's the thing. Kind of like with my earlier experience with the Order of St. Luke and saying yes, and once those walls go down, it's all about the walls not being there. I had no blocks to saying yes to that because I trusted these people. There was no fear in that circle of prayer. And so if you're praying with people and you have a relationship with them and they trust you, they're going to be willing to lean into more things. Does that make sense? Just like in any relationship. So when they started praying with me, it was like almost immediate, just started. And I'm 16 and I'm like, okay. So then what I would do is anytime I would hear an ambulance or emergency things, I would just naturally break into that, whether mostly silently. But now as I have developed over the years with it, sometimes I use it a lot in prayer teams. But I always ask with permission, and this is important, if I'm in the prayer team with people, would it be okay with you if I pray in my prayer language over you? Because we don't want to offend or block people or make them feel uncomfortable. So just like when we pray with people in prayer teams, is it okay if I put my hands on your shoulders? Is it okay if I anoint you with oil? We are trained in the Order of St. Luke to always ask permission first. So the same thing with the Holy Spirit. It's for the common good. I don't want to offend. I don't want to block someone. So if they say, oh, yes, please, then then we got the green light. We're like, let's go. Holy Spirit, activate, 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 right? So and then you just let God do God, and it's whatever that is. And anyway, I don't know if Rich is watching live or not. I know Rachel was on, so hi, Rachel. I'm going to give you a shout out. That's my niece. She already gave me feedback on the phone. It's really sweet. But my brother would do this funny thing, and when we would talk about tongues, he's like, oh, is that thing, you know, when mom says, like, havenagedahanagedaha, is that what that is? We're like, yep, that's tongues. And he would, we're like, yep, that's what it is. So anyway, I want to say to be open to all, but definitely ask Jesus, because he knows, he's way, way wiser than we all are. Ask him what he wants to give to you, and do not be afraid. So those are the gifts. So what are they? What gift of the Holy Spirit do you most desire today? Same again, and if there's one in particular you really like, I do want you to write it down or just think about it again. So there's wisdom, say wisdom, faith, healing, prophecy, miracles, discernment, knowledge, and tongues. Okay, so what's going to happen now is we're going to go into a time of meditation where we go to the Tree of Life. But before that happens, Kathy is going to sing over all of you on Eagle's Wings, which is going to be our preparation. So before that happens, I just want you to put any paper, put any things down. When she sings this, I would invite you to close your eyes and put your hands out into the open receiving position. And sometimes as you're doing a meditation or praying, you might feel a little warmth in the palm of your hands, and that's the Holy Spirit just resting on your hands, and that's really a beautiful thing when that happens. So if you can just close your eyes, take a deep breath in through your nose, out through your mouth, and just start relaxing. And just start right now. Just say, Jesus, Lord Jesus, what gift of the Holy Spirit do you want me to receive today? Lord, we know you're the God of blessings. We know you're good. We know you're the God of light. So would you bless each person here as they most need, and that will most help them in the common good of life and wherever their life leads them. We bind any fear right now in Jesus' name. We just send it to the pit where it belongs. And we put a protective time over this On Eagle's Wings song and over this meditation. And we give it to you. And we just pray that you bless it according to your will. Kathy?
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in the shadow of life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine
his hand.
Okay, with your eyes closed, keep your eyes closed. We're going to go right into the meditation now. So I want you to close your eyes and have your hands out in the receiving position, because God wants to bless you with fruits of the Spirit and gifts of the Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is here. The Holy Spirit is your friend, the Holy Spirit is your advocate, and the Holy Spirit is all about empowerment and blessings. Thank you, Jesus, for the gifts that you are going to give today to bless and empower and nurture and encourage. And we just give you this guided meditation and ask that you protect it. Bless our imaginations and our confidence in you and with you and through you. And thank you that you are with us always, that you are a good God who is the lover of our souls. And we give you this meditation. So now with your, I want you to take another deep breath in through your nose, out through your mouth, and relax. Take another breath in through your nose, out through your mouth, and relax. With your God-given gift of imagination, you see before you a beautiful field with sunshine and birds that are just flying around, and you hear the birds chirping. You can see butterflies. You can see bunnies hopping around. It is a beautiful field. There might be some wild daisies or buttercups in the field. It is a warm, beautiful day, and you can feel the sun on your shoulders and on your face. Beautiful, peaceful, peaceful field. And in this field, as you look ahead, there is the most beautiful tree, just big, gorgeous tree with big branches and sparkling leaves, and just full of the most beautiful fruit of all different kinds that you have ever seen in your whole life. And the fruit is, some of it is red, and some is blue, and some is yellow, some is green, some is orange. All the colors of the rainbow are on this tree, full to overflowing. And the Lord Jesus Christ is standing at the base of the tree, and he's waving, "Friend, come here. I want to share this tree with you that I created. I have been here since the beginning of time. I have been with you always and always will be. And I want you to come right now." And you see this step stool and this ladder, a very, very secure ladder with angels on each side of the ladder holding it for you so you cannot fall. And they're there greeting you as well, smiling from ear to ear, because they know it's a day of celebration, that you have said yes to God, and they're waving you on, and they say, "Come to the tree of life and the tree of the fruit of the Spirit and climb." And they give you this beautiful, like, shoulder bag that's all just like a woven, beautiful bag that can be whatever color or design you want it to be. And it's over your shoulder, and it's on you. So when you climb up this ladder secured by angels, you just start picking. Jesus invites you. Choose and pick as many of the fruits of the Spirit as you like, and just put them in your bag, because they are going to become part of you. They are yours. So without hesitation, you just start picking the fruits from this tree and putting them in this bag that's over your shoulder, that you can just put into the pockets of it so securely. They go in, and you just start filling it up. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and self-control are all there. And I'm going to give you a moment just to enjoy the picking and the delicious fruit. Some of you might even want to taste the fruit. Taste and see that the Lord is good. He invites you to taste and see. And I'm going to give you time to let Jesus do whatever he wants to do with you with this tree, because who knows what else is happening in this time, so I'm going to stop talking for 2 minutes as you just enjoy your time with Jesus. If you want to talk with him about the fruit as you're gathering, you may have this time with Jesus now to enjoy the harvest is plenty. Enjoy the fruits and filling your bag with Jesus and the angels right now. And as you enjoy, finish filling up your bag and eating or whatever it is you're doing with these fruits, Jesus says these are yours to keep and they are yours to give then now to others. So you safely now come down from the ladder, from the tree. You might even want to give the angels a hug on your way down. They are just grinning from ear to ear. It's still a beautiful sunny day, and when you come down to the bottom of the tree and the ladder with your bag full to overflowing, it doesn't even feel heavy. You're just joy filled. Jesus is there sitting on a bench now, like a park bench, and he waves to you to come over and he pats the bench and say, come here and sit next to me. And so you go and sit next to Jesus on this bench, and he says, I have a gift for you, my beloved child. I am well pleased with you. I adore you. I love you. I know how to best bless you. I want to give you a gift from me, a gift of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, so you can bless others. And he hands you this big, beautifully wrapped box with one of those lids that just comes right off very easily, but it has like a bow on the top of it. And you take the top of the gift off and you just look inside. And I'm just going to give you a few moments here, because it could be anything that Jesus wants to give you. It could be even beyond what we have talked about. So I want to give you time right now to talk to Jesus about what he wants to give you, what is in that box, and also if you have something on your heart or mind that you want to ask him for specifically, I want to give you some time right now with the creation of the world, who loves you, knows every hair on your head, and has known you from the beginning of time, since you were in your mother's womb, who hovers over you now. Let him minister to you as you talk to him. So I'm going to stop talking for the next 2 minutes for you to just have time with Jesus right now.
Thank you.
And if you want to be healed from something in your own body or mind or heart, do not be afraid to ask Jesus right now, because the Lord of the universe can lay hands on you right there on that park bench. So have no fear. If you want to ask for healing right now from Jesus, then I encourage you to do so. What is Jesus doing right now? What is he doing? And as you're sitting there with Jesus, I want you now to just see him just with his arm around you as a friend and as Savior. And as he puts his arm around you and you lean into him and maybe even put your head on his shoulder, hear him say these words to you. You are my beloved child, and you hear your name, with whom I am well pleased. I am so glad you came to me again to ask for what you need. I am here to be your Savior, your leader, your light, your law, your healer. Whatever you need in the name of Jesus, I want you to be whole. I want you to be whole, my child. I want you to be whole. And so he anoints your forehead in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit to receive the blessings of God Almighty, to have more the mind of Christ and the peace of Christ in your mind. He blesses your heart and puts his hand on your heart, that your heart would receive the love of the Savior of the world that he has for you. He saw what he had made in the world, and he sees that you are good. You are loved by the Creator of the universe. And you put your hands out to him, and he takes both of your hands in his palms. Both of your hands. He cups them in his palms because he holds us in the palm of his almighty hands. They are mighty, and you feel the warmth of those almighty hands. And he says, you are mine. I will never leave you or forsake you. Be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid, for I go with you wherever you go. I go before you, behind you, above you, within you. I am who I am. And you are my beloved. And I love you. Receive that love from Jesus right now. And any healing that would come out of his body that would go into yours, because if you can just touch his cloak, you will be healed. Not only are you touching his cloak, the hands of the Almighty are holding your hands in his hands. It is personal. It is intimate. It is safe. It is beautiful. And now he takes your face and he cups your beautiful face in his hands and he looks in your eyes and he says, I adore you. I bless you with these gifts that I have given you of the fruits of the Spirit and the gifts of the Spirit that I give you. Go now, child, into the world to bless others in my name. You have the authority in my name to bless and heal. Do you not know that? And you say, Lord, I know. Lord, I know, I know. Help my unbelief, but Lord, I know. And you receive, you say, I receive this blessing from you, Jesus. Say, I receive this blessing from you, Jesus. I receive these gifts from you, Jesus. I receive these gifts from you, Jesus. I am so thankful. I am so thankful. And with that, you give him another giant hug, and you've got the fruit on you and in you if you've eaten some of it, and you have this giant gift that you're going to just, you have it, whatever it is, and you receive it, and you're just so thankful, and you get up and you wave and you just say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You're healing me now. Thank you, Jesus. You're healing me now. Thank you, Jesus, you're loving me now. Thank you, Jesus, you're loving me now. Thank you, Jesus, you're blessing me now. Thank you, Jesus, you're blessing me now. I am going to go into the world to bless and heal in your name. I am your warrior. I am your warrior. Say, I am your warrior. I am armored up. I am armored up, and now I'm gifted up. Say, I am gifted up. I am gifted up to go into the world to bless and heal in your name. And so you leave happy and skipping and hopping and juggling all these gifts you've received. You don't even know, like, so many. What do I do with all these gifts? There's so many, but you're so grateful. And so what I am going to invite you into now, into a time of blessing and thanksgiving, you wave to Jesus and you say goodbye, and when you're ready, you come back into the room. But what we're going to do now is we're just going to start saying with words the thank yous. We're going to just start praising God and just saying words over and over again. So you can say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Alleluia, alleluia. Praise you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Whatever words that you feel like you want to say of gratitude, I want you to start saying them out loud. And I'm going to ask that Neil on Zoom to unmute people. And this can get a little, we might get a little feedback, but for 30 seconds, we're all going to be praising Jesus together so we can hear everyone, because it doesn't matter what it sounds like, because it's all praise. So Neil, for 30 seconds.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for all of you. Thank you, Father. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you for everything. Everything you've done. You've been such a blessing. And thank you for loving me and healing me. Praise you, God. I thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. For Sheikha Lakaka. For Sheila Kaka. For Sheikha Lakaka. For Ludikika. Sheikha Lakaka. Sheikha Lakaka.
You light the world into singing the glory.
Lord's face with
I invite you to join us, and thank you everyone for joining in that praise. We love hearing from all of you. We encourage you to keep praising the Lord, and Kathy is going to sing some of our closing songs as we sing together. Blessed be your name, and then how great is our God. So I invite all of you here in person to go ahead and stand as we sing these last songs together with Kathy. Okay, go ahead, Kathy.
Blessed be your name, the land that is plentiful, where your streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. When I'm found in the desert place, though I walk through the wilderness, blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be your name when the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name on the road marked with suffering. Though there's pain in the offering, blessed be your name.
Rejoice, let all the earth rejoice.
his voice and trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Say with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God. And age to age he stands, and time is in his hands, beginning and the end, beginning and the end. The God, the three in one, Father, Spirit, Son, the Lion and the Lamb, the Lion and the Lamb. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And I will see how great, how great is our God.
We know this to be true. His
name above all names, worthy of all praise. My heart will sing.
Thank you, Kathy. Thank you. Kathy's on. Everyone, big round of applause for Kathy. Yes, we love you. What a joy, what a joy, what a joy. Thank you to all the sound guys again. They all did an amazing job. Thank you to all of them again. Yay. It has been a joy and a pleasure to be with you all. We wish it didn't have to end, but our Zoom time is coming to a close. I'm going to invite the Chris, the Convener, can we get the hand mic on? She's going to do a blessing over everyone. And then I do want to invite you all, the people here in person, please stay. We're going to induct Gail. We're going to induct Chris. We're going to have communion. We will have a potty break between that. We're going to have a time of prayer. If you are not a member of the Order of St. Luke and you would be like to be inducted into it, I can do that as well. For anyone here in person, I can get my hands on you. I would love to. So you're invited to be inducted into the Order of St. Luke after this. And for those of you on Zoom, we invite you again to become a part of the OSL family. Just go to osltoday.org and become a member today. We would love to have you as part of the family. The other thing on your handout sheets, there is also the Zoom prayer link info. You can go to a Zoom prayer room and be prayed over. You make an appointment for that. Anyone could go to the Zoom prayer room to do that and be prayed over. There's an OSL prayer wall link in there where you can go to the prayer wall and put any prayer requests up. Anyone can do that anytime, and people from around the world will pray for your requests. You can become a part of the online 26 study. Classes are starting on Zoom all the time. And we want you to come to Vancouver, Washington in October 20th, 22nd and come to the North American Conference. It will be like this times 100. Like the infusion of the Holy Spirit, it's going to be like a family reunion of OSL getting together in person that we haven't been able to do in years. and people from all over the United States and Canada, and all our new Canadian friends, whoever that person was from Canada that came on our Zoom to give a testimony, could you please put your name and contact into the chat so I can reach out to you personally? And Neil, can you make sure you write that down? Because I definitely want to reach out to you. Okay. So thank you for being with us. Chris is going to say the Irish blessing. And then Kathy, we're all going to go out singing This Little Light of Mine, because now you're all infused, fired up, fire, Holy Spirit filled, gift filled to go out into the world. And you're literally going to go out into the world singing and being and doing This Little Light of Mine. And everybody says, Amen. Okay, is it on?
All you brought to us today, we're so grateful that we had you here with us. Yes, this was such a blessed time with you. Thank you, dear. And here is the Irish blessing we have for you today. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and the rain fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the hollow of his hand. Amen.
Amen. And all right, oh, go ahead.
Thank you again, everyone who is here today, in person and online. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Kathy, bring us home. This little light of mine. Everyone get up again. If you're at home, everyone get up.
I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine.
Great job.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Bye. Beautiful.
Love you.
Thank you.
Bye. I got to go. Patient reading.
God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, Kathy.
Thank you.
Blessings.
Blessings, Kathy.
Bye, Teresa. Bye, Diane.
Bye-bye.
Bye.